So what we're doing is we're combining technology we've had with the power of cloud processing, which is a really novel approach to smartphone photography. I don't think we've seen it elsewhere in the field yet. And by using the power of the cloud, we're able to make videos so much better.
Welcome to the Made by Google podcast, where we meet the people who work on the Google products you love. Here's your host, Rashid Finch.
Today, we're talking to Kevin Fu, product manager for the Pixel camera, and Lillian Chen, a senior product manager for the Google Photos experience on Pixel. They know everything about Video Boost, a feature that improves the quality of videos with enhanced lighting and color, especially at night.
This is the Made by Google podcast.
Empower everyone to easily and beautifully capture life's moments. Kevin, that's the mission statement you have on the internal Google directory. Can you tell us a little bit about why you picked that?
Yeah, sure. I feel like we're all super busy working on different projects. You know, so many things going on at work. So I find it very important to always kind of remember why we're doing what we're doing. So like, why do people take photos with their camera? People essentially use their camera as a tool to capture moments so that they can create, remember, and connect with others. So it's like a very personal experience. I like this mission statement because it reminds myself, how do we make it easy for them to capture those moments? How do we make sure that the moments they capture are as good or even better than they saw in real life? I think most importantly, empowering everyone here just means that we're building a camera for anyone in the world, regardless of their background, their age, their gender, their skin tone, and et cetera. I like to use this mission statement to remind, you know, why we're building camera.
So you are on the Pixel camera team. Something I learned over the past few years is that there are both people who are like hardcore into photography, maybe as a hobby before joining the team. And then some people, they're not so much into it, which equally is useful when creating a camera. But I'm just wondering, like, what is your background in that sense?
Yeah, so I wouldn't say I'm like a hardcore photographer. I would say I'm a hobbyist. I take a lot of photos with my Pixel. I take photos with my mirrorless camera very, very occasionally. But I would say I'm mostly a hobbyist when it comes to photography.
Amazing. Lillian, welcome back to the Made by Google podcast. You were here when we were talking about the Audio Magic Eraser, another amazing feature of Pixel. What have you been up to since then?
So great to be back. After working on Audio Magic Eraser that we launched last October, I've been working on other features we also announced at Made by Google. And then I've also been busy, of course, working on new features and feature upgrades for Pixel 9. So it's definitely a busy season right now.
Lillian, for people who don't know what Video Boost is, how would you explain what it does?
I would say that kind of the goal of Video Boost is to unlock the best video quality ever that you've seen on a smartphone. And we're just starting on Pixel 8 Pro to do that for our users. In terms of how it does that, it combines kind of technology we've used for a long time in Pixel camera for still images, but that's really expensive, computationally expensive to do on a smartphone. So what we're doing is we're combining technology we've had with the power of cloud processing, which is a really novel approach to smartphone photography. I don't think we've seen it elsewhere in the field yet. And by using the power of the cloud, we're able to make videos so much better.
And one of those areas where it does make videos better is when it's really, really dark. So it reminds me of night sight, which we had for photography, I think since Pixel 3. I actually remember the first time I saw it in action and was like, is this even real? And it turned out, fortunately, it was real. So is the goal with Video Boost to have like a similarly transformative impact on video capture?
Yes, that is. I think when we first started out this project and we're trying to talk to different users about where they were happy with their video quality and where they weren't, low light video was still an area where people very quickly named as those are instances in which their video were better. And these are users who are using top of the line phones, right? So fairly happy users, but still saw a need, a user need for improvement. So when we thought about what we would want to use Video Boost to make better for users, night sight was top of our list of something we wanted to try to apply to video.
So Kevin, videos are often like taking sort of pictures 30 times a second. So I guess you took night sight, you multiplied it by 30, and that was the end of the workday, right?
It's not a copy and paste, unfortunately. It would have made our lives a lot easier. Video just much more complex than photos in terms of both in a computational sense and in a quality sense. So we need to solve for both. The first problem, fortunately, it's a much easier one to solve for our case. So night sight essentially works by aligning and merging multiple frames. So you take multiple frames in order to get a really good, really high quality frame. And you have to do that for like 30 frames per second, depending on your setting. So that's typically how night sight works. But thanks to cloud computing, we can process them with a lot more freedom. We can process them in a less constrained fashion. So we can decide how many frames that we want to align and merge and how are we going to merge them. We can even take this to another level. We can even do much better. We can even run more complex algorithms simultaneously. For example, we can run deblurring, we can run stabilization, we can run color correction. So we can run a lot of very heavy computations. It's all possible because of cloud processing. So that's the first challenge that fortunately was easier to solve. The second challenge is an interesting one. It's a uniquely video problem that a lot of people didn't realize. So if you think about it, a photo is really just one single photo. If it looks good, it looks good. But for video, it's like 30 photos a second. So it's important that we take consistency into account. We call it internally the temporal consistency. So imagine if you look at a video being played back, and if you see this weird flickering of brightness, if you all of a sudden you see this color shift, it would be a very jarring experience. So that's what we spend a lot of time and effort to get right. We want to make sure that when you look at Video Boost video, you don't get this random flickering of brightness. You don't get this random changes of colors. So yes, I would say one of the biggest challenges with bringing a lot of these photo algorithms into video, temporal consistency, it's something that we have to get right.
I'm just wondering, what is the single biggest technical hurdle? Maybe it was that one, but maybe there's another one in bringing Video Boost to life, Lillian. What initially seemed impossible?
Yeah, well, what Kevin just talked about seems really hard to me. but something else that we had to get over in the early days of Video Boost is figuring out how do we even use the cloud for processing images. It's something Pixel Camera has never done before. We've always been focused on on-device, really fast processing. So what seemed both like a bit impossible, but also like a paradigm shift for our users in the beginning was this question we asked ourselves, well, what would happen if we didn't constrain ourselves to on-device real-time processing? What if we could unlock the best of Google's computational photography and AI by using the cloud? So to build Video Boost, we needed to bring together a new end-to-end imaging pipeline that bridged both Pixel Camera app on-device and Google Photos servers, something that didn't exist before. We also needed to bridge, as I said before, the pipeline to the Photos cloud where we could then apply a set of algorithms. So to do this, we had to hire specific people for their skill set so that our engineering team had the right expertise. And we're also really lucky to have really smart people from camera, from Google Research with AI expertise and knowledge about computational photography, as well as people who understood how to even do ML processing in the cloud. And we also got a lot of advice from people who had experience with video backup and video server infrastructure.
I guess with a feature like Video Boost, you don't know how great it is until it's built, right? It's maybe a research paper, but you don't know how effective it is until you see it for the first time. So question to both of you, when did you realize that this feature had true potential?
Yeah, I think for me, it was probably when I first saw the very first Nightsight video demo. We are all very familiar with how Nightsight photos look, right? It's not that surprising. But to see it in video for the first time, it was just, we've never seen anything like that before. So I remember when we saw the before video, it was a very dark video of someone's neighborhood, right? It was very dark, couldn't really see a lot of things. And when the team told us, hey, the cloud process result finally came back, and we all were very excited to see it. And we were just stunned by how bright and how clean it was. And I think what's interesting is that it even revealed things that we didn't realize was in the shot. Like there was this big red car parked in the street that we were only able to see because of the boosted video. So I think that was the moment when I thought, you know, we had something that's going to be exciting for our users.
Lillian, did you see that same video or did you see something else the first time from Video Boost?
The early demos were really exciting, I think, for sure. So I think Kevin's example is great. But I think for me, Video's Boost potential to really let users really hit home. As you mentioned, Rashid, when we're kind of later in the stages of our development process, when we started our internal dog food, that's when we let Google employees start testing our features. We ran a Video Boost Halloween contest to get people to use it and give us feedback. And all the examples from that contest is what got me really excited because Video Boost would take videos that were captured at dusk or nighttime with lots of Halloween lights, orange decorations, and make them look really awesome, just really vibrant, really well lit. And then just the energy and participation we saw with that competition from our dog fooders also made me really excited for our launch.
I think what stands out about Video Boost and the way it works that it is a combination of on-device and cloud processing. So what is the benefit of this hybrid approach and how do you balance speed and quality, Kevin?
I think to put simply, hybrid approach is basically giving you the best of both worlds. We give you a great video and we give you an even better video. So what do I mean by that? When you take a video boost video, we actually give you two videos, right? We give you a on-device process video that's fast, that's ready to go. You can view it, play it, share it immediately if you want. We call it the initial video. But we also give you a second video that's cloud process. That's going to take a bit of wait time, but it's going to give you a much better quality video. So that's your boosted cloud process video. I would say for the most scenes, our initial video or our on-device process video, it's more than enough to give you a stunning looking video. It runs what we call Live HDR Plus, which is a machine learning based HDR Plus algorithm that's single frame. And we actually build it right into our tensor chip. So it's going to be able to run very efficiently. It's going to give you that same punch and vibrance that people love from our HDR Plus photo right into our video, right? It does that. In low light, we also have techniques that we use, such as pixel binning, which is essentially combining four adjacent pixels into one giant pixel that gives it four times the light sensitivity. We also use dual exposure. You know, so we did a lot of things to make it look good, even in low light. So I would say the on-device process initial video is already pretty good. But like Lillian mentioned, those that come into video boost, they want the best of the best. So this is when the boosted video comes into play. So in cloud processing, what we do is we take that already pretty great initial video, we just build on top of it. We make it 10 times better by processing our state-of-the-art video algorithms like HDR+, like Night Sight, like Video on Blur, and all that good stuff, and generate a video that's much, much better. So if you're someone that wants to share video on social media, like immediately, you can just take that initial video. Or if you're someone like me who's always looking for the best quality, you know, I don't really share videos to social immediately. I'm the type of guy that likes to, you know, before bed, curate my video a little bit, edit my video a little bit. And if you're someone like that, then Video Boost is for you.
Now, Kevin, just to be sure, we talked a lot about Video Boost at night, but does it have any benefit in the daylight as well?
Yeah, absolutely. Video Boost in daylight is going to process HDR+, which, you know, the benefits I think a lot of people are familiar with. You know, it's going to give your video this extra punch of color. It's going to give your video more contrast, more details. And on top of that, we also have a lot of improvements with stabilizations. Yeah, so if you shoot Video Boost videos in the daylight, you're going to find the video to be very pleasing looking.
I think the beauty of this all is that all the complexity that Kevin and his team is working on, me as a user, I don't need to know anything about it. I just, I guess, have to turn it on. So maybe tell us, where do I turn it on?
Yeah, that's right. So to turn on Video Boost, first go to your Pixel camera app and enter video mode by tapping that little video icon at the bottom of your screen. And then visit video settings by tapping the gear icon on the bottom right hand side of your screen. You'll see in the list of settings, Video Boost is the second one. So when you turn it on, Video Boost is on. You'll notice that if you're trying it for the very, very first time, it might default to 4K setting because we're trying to help maximize the quality of your Video Boost. But you can always change it back to full HD if that's your preference. And then we also highly encourage people to try Video Boost with 10-bit HDR turned on as well. But you'll see that, yeah, certain settings can be on or off combined with Video Boost.
We now can establish that AI can help improve video quality. Are there any other areas in smartphone videography where AI can potentially assist and improve what people are making?
I would say beyond quality, we know that users want to express themselves creatively. Some users aspire to create these very cinematic looking videos like the professionals, but they're having a hard time doing that today because in between just getting good looking video frames and a professionally made video production, there are a lot of steps along the way. So I think an area in AI for videography that I'm personally very excited about is how can we make that creative workflow simpler for our users, for everyday users? How can we democratize pro-grade videography or cinematography so that anyone, regardless of their skill level, can just produce professional looking videos? That's an area where I'm excited to see AI push forward in videography.
Now, this season in the Made by Google podcast, we give our Pixel superfans the opportunity to ask a question to the guests of the podcast. And we got a question this time from Edgar Martinez, and he wants to know if Video Boost could work completely on the Pixel device itself. Great question, Edgar. So what do you think? Is it possible at some point in the future, perhaps?
Yeah, really great question. I would say, you know, today's quality that you see on Video Boost is only possible with the help of the cloud right now. And that's because, as we mentioned, there's all this heavy computational photography done in parallel on the cloud, done frame by frame, and it would require so much compute power. That type of compute power doesn't exist on smartphones today. But I think the good news is that we'll keep working to make our on-device video quality better and better as well. And this is where kind of Kevin can talk about our plans for on-device video.
Yeah, in terms of on-device video, you know, we're always going to be improving year over year. I think many years ago when we first introduced HDR Plus to still photos, we didn't think it was possible to lend it in video. But as the technology evolves, our research team was able to come up with a clever solution to bring that to on-device video with live HDR Plus that, you know, I just kind of talked about. So the same thing, as the technologies evolve, as the on-device capability evolve, we're definitely going to see more and more technologies and use cases lending in the on-device video. So that's very top of mind for us.
Now, we love to offer our listeners a top tip, something they should definitely try with the feature or product you created. So when we talk about Video Boost on Pixel 8 Pro, what is definitely one specific thing they should try with it?
Yeah, bonus tip. I would say choose low light scenes with a lot of colors. Try to take Video Boost videos in dark places with a lot of colors. Think cityscapes at night, night markets, art shows, or team lab. For those of you who don't know, is an amazing light show in Japan, right? You will get really, really incredible shots with Video Boost there. You will gonna see Video Boost magically amplify the colors in the dark. So really, really cool. I recommend people trying it out.
Thank you so much for creating Video Boost. And I also say that as a father of young kids, like, you know, creating videos of them just before they go to sleep in a dark bedroom, I think even a year ago was impossible to sort of capture these moments. So thank you also as a dad for creating that feature. And thanks for joining the Made by Google podcast, Kevin, Lillian.
Thank you so much. Great to be here.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
Thank you for listening to the Made by Google podcast. Don't miss out on new episodes. Subscribe now wherever you get your podcasts to be the first to listen.